Hello everyone, welcome to another t-shirt design video. Now in this video I am going to make a very basic t-shirt design. This one is a, as you can see, this is going to be a workout fitness related t-shirt design. Now in this one I am going to show you guys how to make a design without using too many vectors, because at the first place we go for vectors and try to make something with vectors, but vectors are really to support our text, not to, they are not the main part of our design. Like, people do not buy any design, they buy the message. If this message is related to you, then you will buy this t-shirt. If you are not a fitness freak, then how good this design will be, it doesn't matter, you are not going to buy this. But if you are a fitness freak, you like to do workouts, then if the design is not very good but the message is relating with you, you will maybe buy the t-shirt. So that's the main point here. Now as you can see here, I am going to place my text like this. Now this magic text and the workouts, these are two my focus text here. Obviously this workouts is the main focus text here, magic is just to support the text. Now I am going to use some very basic fonts here, like I don't believe in. Make them two lines like this. You can see my keyboard strokes here. So this believe in, I am going to maybe use my Explorer serif font, kind of this one. And then this I don't, I am going to make it like Explorer scripted version. I am using all the Explorer fonts here, just some variation of the family here. Now I'm going to align them center wise like this. And then this magic text, I'm going to use my this text for the theme here, or maybe just let's use another font, Narmada. I really like this font, so let's change the font here. This is the two font I'm going to use here. Now okay, let's create a, I'm going to make this text a little curve here, so let's create an ellipse here, kind of this. Then I'm going to press Shift X. Shift X will make it fill. If it is in a stroke right now, if I press Shift X, that makes it fill, and if I press Shift X, that makes fill a stroke. I hope you know this. So I'm selecting that ellipse here. Go to tripod path tool and then click on the anchor point and press Ctrl V. So this is going to place like this. So I don't believe in magic. This clip in, I am going to just place like this. Then this I don't, I am going to place kind of this. Then this magic is going to be the focus text, of course. First focus text will be the magic text. Now that is fine. This clip in, I am going to make it this font, but a bit smaller in size. And then this workouts, so let's not use that font. I'm going to keep it kind of bigger. So as you can see guys, this is how I'm going to place my text, and I am not going to make it a very fancy or complex t-shirt design. I just want to keep it as simple as possible. So that's why I'm going to, let's first of all break the font so that I can align them perfectly. That is fine. So as this is going to be a t-shirt design for fitness or gym category, so we can use some graphics here, like some vectors that related to the gym, or we can just make it with the text only. But this kind of styles, it just looks good with a related graphic or a small graphic, like something related to gym or fitness. So I'm going to use kind of that. So I'm going to make them a bit overlapping with each other, of course here, then this one also, then maybe this one. I just want to make it focus on the text first of all. So let's select out this I don't text. I'm making an offset path for it. If you don't know how to make an offset path, you have to go to, let's cut it first. You have to go to object path, and then here offset path, I'm using the shortcut key. So if I select my this believe in text, open the transparency, press Ctrl F. So this is going to place in like this. As you can see, it is creating this cutout effect here. That is I think fine. So let's select this magic text here. Again, I'm going to create that same size stroke. It is 10 pixel offset path. It may vary depending on the size of your text or graphics you are working. So I'm placing it here. Let's copy this, and then I will, this workout text is my main focus text, so I'm going to bring that a bit down. Now for this one here, I'm going to bring my ruler tool here. So if you want, don't have this ruler tool, you have to press Ctrl R, or you can go to Windows and then ruler somewhere like this. Okay, I don't know where that goes. Okay, don't worry, just press Ctrl R and the ruler will be activated. So I'm placing these two in that area so that I can make sure that it is not going outside of my, of the wide of my design, kind of this. Then let's create a stroke from here and here, like between these two ruler, so that it can be a, I can apply some effect to the stroke, like this part, like that, then maybe same size in this area. So these three, if I select them, I can align them center wise, because this workout is my focus text. I'm making them a group, Ctrl G to group. So that is my focus text. That's why I keep them in a boundary, you can say. So that is fine, I think. Now maybe for this one, I'm going to make it a bit bigger or a smaller, I believe in. So let's bring that a bit up. Now, as you can see here, are, it is making a empty space in this two side. We can use a graphics there if you want. So this is a free to download bundle from FreePic. You can download them for free, of course. Now I'm using this a small dumbbell set here. Now this is a pre-made vector, so it is made with something different style. So let's first trim it, and once it is trimmed, I can select my magic wand tool, then click on this white and delete. So it is going to delete everything that is in white. Let's, it is just keeping the this color. Let's make it complete black. So once it is complete black, I can use it. So my plan is to keep them like in this area, but I want to make sure that it is aligning with the, okay, I don't want to overlap this with any of my text, kind of this much is good. Then I will need to bring this to a bit down like this, or I can make it overlap, no problem. Just making the, making some space between the text, because it is not, I don't want to keep them all kind of close to each other. So this part I want it to come like here in this area, but it is overlapping with that part. So if I double click, this vector is going to be isolated. Now if I select, press A, or if I click on this direct selection tool, I can select this part, a specific part only. Then if I bring that in this area, I can do that. I just want everything to keep inside the roller area, that is fine, and double click to isolate. So as you can see, this is how it is looking right now. Let's bring this a bit down, then maybe this one also a bit down, or I can make it a bit bigger here because there are some space, I can do that, that's fine. So this magic text, if I select this blip in text inside the transparency, I will find this offset path of the magic. I am selecting this, copy. Now if I click here on this dumbbell, double click to open the transparency, press Ctrl F. So Ctrl F is going to paste in front, that means in exact same place. So this is how it is looking right now. And as you can see, with just a simple graphic, we can represent our this design really good, in a good way. So I can use some more elements from here, but I wanted to just make it a simple, as simple as possible. So that's why, let's use a barbell here. I don't know what it calls, maybe weightlifting or something, I don't really know. So I'm just going to make it, okay, let's not vectorize the design, let's keep it simple and clean, kind of this area, maybe this much. Then if I select this two, I can align them center wise. So this is going to be my final design. As you can see, I am not using too many vectors here. These two I am just using to represent the fitness category, the fitness, like the equipment that people use to in their fitness training or something like that. when they are working out. So maybe this will attract the girls, because this is the kind of boys thing, and this is kind of girls do. I don't really know that. So let's add one more element here, because this area is looking like a bit empty for me. So I can really fill that up, and this area is looking kind of empty for me. So if I select the star, I can create offset path of it, kind of this much. Then if I press shift X, that is going to turn into a stroke, as you can see. So this is going to be the, okay, let's not overlap here. I'm just filling the area here, nothing else. So I'm going to expand it, because there are strokes in the design. And that's it, guys. If I select everything, Control G to group it, I can simply expand everything. So there is no other color than just black, complete black color. And this is how you can easily create a cool looking fitness design, because I have some more advanced tutorial on like gym t-shirt, fitness t-shirt, but this one I wanted to make it really simple and clean, like anyone can do kind of design. And you can see we are just focusing on the text. So for supporting our text, we are using some vector graphics that is related to the niche. We are not using vectors to support our text. So here the vectors are just a part of my design, not the main focus area of the design. And I hope anyone can try this or make something cool like this with just a little practice. And that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you learned something new. See you in the next video, guys. Have a great time. Thank you, everyone.